Hi everyone, my name is Glenda Sparling with SureFit Designs, and today I'd like to introduce to you the newest component to the SureFit Designs dress kit, and it is the Master Pattern Collar Collection. You know, up until now, when you've wanted a collar for your blouse or your dress, you've needed to draw it, and the instructions, of course, are in the dress book to do that. Well, with input from my customers, we've gone ahead and created a Master Pattern Collar Collection so that you can draw off your collars even that much quicker and easier. I'm going to show you how to draw these collars off. But first of all, what I need to do is just explain a little bit about the different categories of collars. There is flat, rolled, and standing. A flat collar means that that collar is going to lay flat against your shoulders, like a Peter Pan collar or a sailor collar. The outer edge is really wide so that it will lay flat on your shoulders. Then there is the rolled collar, and that's often called a convertible collar. That's where the collar comes up against your neckline and then rolls over, and some of it still lays on your shoulder line. Convertible collars are called that because they can be button closed or worn open. And then there's the standing collar, and that's like a Mandarin collar, Chinese collar, or even a turtleneck. Even with a turtleneck, the high one, when that upper edge is the same circumference as the neck edge, when it rolls over, it's still never going to lay on your shoulders. All right, so what's the first thing you're going to do? Well, you need to measure the neckline of your bodice. Now, that neckline that's on the Master Pattern bodice front and back, that's the high jewel neckline, and that just sits right at the base of your neck. But when you go to add a collar, you're likely going to want a little bit more breathing and swallowing room, and you're going to want a little bit of room for the turn of the cloth on a collar. So what you're going to do is take a look at your bodice front and your bodice back. You can join them together at the shoulder seam, and this gives you a little bit better perspective of what to do at the neckline here. Now, you can lower it an eighth of an inch or a quarter of an inch all the way around. You could lower the front and not the back, or you could lower the back a little bit and then the front might, you know, it might be lowered a half to 5/8 of an inch. It just all depends where you want that neckline to fit on your body. You might even want to make a slight V-neck, and then your collar extends from that. So then, once you've got your collar or your neckline modified in terms of length, then what you'll want to do is take your tape measure, stand it on edge, and take an accurate length measurement of the front neckline edge and the back neckline edge, and record those two length measurements independent of one another. And then we'll take a look at the collar collection. There are a number of different collars for you here to choose from, and a number of them have different front options on them as well, so there's lots of choices here. There's the Peter Pan collar, and now here's the collar for the stand and a collar stand, much like the blouse that I am wearing. Then there are two more standing collars over here, the Mandarin collar and the standing winged collar. There's your rolled convertible collar and a rolled convertible collar with an attached stand. So there's lots of choices. Let me show you how to draw off, first of all, this winged collar, this standing winged collar. It's kind of a fun one to do. So I'm going to have my stylus handy, but first of all, I'm just going to start tracing this just freehand. And at home, if you're more comfortable, make sure you use your designing stylus to do this. I would actually come back afterward and true this all up with the designing stylus or perhaps with the designer's companion. Now, what I'm doing is I'm drawing up towards the shoulder notch. That is the original shoulder notch on the master pattern. And what I need to do is I need to measure how much distance I've got from that shoulder notch to center front. And on the master pattern, that is 4.5 inches. Well, let's just say that your front neckline length is 5 inches. So I know I need to extend that out 1/2 inch, which is what I will do right there. That's going to be my new shoulder notch, and then I'm going to continue drawing like that. Then you take your tracing vellum and shift it over on top of so that shoulder notches are now lined up. Now you're going to do the back end of your collar, the back side for your back neck. And I will draw this out to the back neck that's on the collar itself, and then I'll measure. From center back to the shoulder notch on the pattern is 3 inches. Let's again, for the sake of example, say that your back neckline is 1/2 inch longer. You're 3.5 inches there. So I'm going to bring this out 1/2 inch there and 1/2 inch here. Then all I do is shift that vellum over on top of the master pattern like this, and then connect the center back. Now, all of these directions for doing this are actually on the reverse side of the collar collection. These collar patterns do not have seam allowances on them. So, in order to cut it out and sew it together, you need to now add seam allowances. So you just take your handy designing stylus that has the seam allowance slots and use it for adding the seam allowances. And of course, you would do that all the way around. And again, please notice that I am drawing this off in a bright colored pen so that you can see what I'm doing. At home, make sure you use a pencil so that if you need to erase anything that you can. And all of these collars are on, have center back on the fold of the fabric. If you want just a one-piece collar to do your layout and cutting, then just obviously trace that off a second time and flop it to the other side. All right, all of the collars are that easy to draw off, but I would like to show you just one more, and that's this Peter Pan collar. In this circumstance, this right here is my neck edge, and this lower edge right here is the outer edge or upper edge of the collar. Now, once again, you do need to measure to see what the length of the collar stitching line for the neckline is on the front, and this is 4.5 inches long. Again, for the example, we've said your neckline is 5 inches long. So I'm going to bring this out 1/2 inch more and line up that marking with the notch on the shoulder on the collar pattern, and then continue in this fashion. And then I'm going to, well, I'll just freehand up to the back neck. Again, if you're more comfortable, please make sure you use your designing stylus to do this like that. Now, measure that back neck curve. This is 3 inches long, and we know that yours is 3.5 inches long. So I'm going to extend out the back neck 1/2 inch on the top and the bottom area here, then just shift that over on top of the pattern and continue drawing, and there's the center back on the fold of the fabric. And there you have it, a Peter Pan collar done to your exact neckline size. Keep in mind, one last thing to do is to put in your seam allowances on that inside edge and of course the outer edge of your collar pattern piece like this. In closing, I would just like to thank each and every one of you for being our customer. You know, it just really gives me no end of pleasure when I open up my emails and I'll see a note that says, remember when, or remember me, and it will take me back 25 years of when I was traveling around the world giving seminars and presentations, and you'll remind me of something that I said or a design that I showed you how to do. Over the years, more and more people have been using SureFit Designs, and I truly am grateful for you as our customer. And I just hope that each and every one of you continue to use SureFit Designs to get the best fit possible that you can for your body shape and size.